This video shows how to install or what to install to get your project set up to program in Civil 3D. The first thing you want to do is download Visual Studio 2019 or whatever the most current release version is. If you're doing it on your home computer, you can most likely download the Community 2019 version, which is free. If you work for a large company, you might have to go with Professional or Enterprise based on Microsoft's licensing agreement with your company. But Community 2019 is free, and lots of people use that version. Once you have Visual Studio and you run the installer, you'll want to add in the projects that are needed or the code. And so you'll want to include the desktop and mobile, the desktop, the .NET desktop development option. I have it checked to do the C++ as well, but that's not required to program in .NET. You'll also want to go to the AutoCAD Developer Center, scroll to the very bottom of the content, and you'll want to install the appropriate AutoCAD .NET wizard for whatever year that you want. I'm going to be using the AutoCAD 2022 .NET wizard. You can let the .NET wizard run and then change the references to whatever year that you want. Some of the older .NET wizards don't work or won't install on Visual Studio 2019. You'll also want to install the Object ARX for Windows for whatever year you're going to be programming in. In this case, I'm using Object ARX for AutoCAD 2022. And so you can download and install that. And then later on when you use the wizard, the .NET wizard, you can point to that location. So I'm going to go ahead and run Visual Studio. I'm going to go ahead and create a new project. Under the search for templates, you can type AutoCAD. And as long as you've installed the .NET wizard, you should see the C# and VB.NET. I'm going to use C# because that's my preferred programming language, but either one will work. On the next tab, you can give your project a name. And I'm going to call this DFWBIUG sample. I'm going to put it in the default location. And then you can choose to have a separate folder, which will put the project in a separate folder than the solution file, or you can have them in the same by having this checkbox. This is my preferred one, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And then for the .NET framework, it's going to be whatever version of AutoCAD that you're running. In this case, 2022 will work with .NET framework 4.7.2. You can then hit create, and that'll open up the AutoCAD .NET wizard configurator. You'll want to point to the location of the acmanage.dll, which is in the Object ARX SDK. And that was provided in the Object ARX download link, already shown. And so just navigate to it. What this will do is it'll make it so when you create your WIN forms, Visual Studio will allow it to be displayed and run. And it has the configurations to do that. If you use the one that's located in the C program files, Autodesk AutoCAD 2022, it'll give you error messages saying it can't load it. And so that's why you want to use the Object ARX SDK version. You then want to specify the AutoCAD executable location. And it's usually going to be in C program files, Autodesk AutoCAD 2022. Here we have the assemblies to reference. By default, it's going to be AutoCAD, but you also have options for Autodesk Architecture, Mechanical, Civil 3D, and Map 3D. I'm going to go ahead and use Civil3D. This is going to add the references for both AutoCAD, Map3D, and Civil3D. In this case, I don't want the Civil3D references, so I'm just going to go ahead and uncheck them from the list. I'm just going to be using .NET programming, so I want to use the AEC base managed and the AEC CDB managed. And these are the API calls that Civil3D will use in .NET. The items below it are all COM references, and that's just a little bit of an older version of programming. And Autodesk recommends that you use the top two options and retire any items that are down here. I'm then going to hit OK. It's going to create the project. And open up Visual Studio. If you double-click on Properties, here's your assembly name and your default namespace. And this is taken from the value that was entered in the project. We have a build, and it's going to put the DLL in this output path. On the Debug tab, we can see that it selected the AutoCAD executable in the listed location, and it added information here. Right now, it's set up to load map, and so we want to change that to C3D because we want to load up Civil3D. If we want to program for data shortcuts or pressure pipe networks, we'll want to add the corresponding DLLs. To do that, we can right-click and choose Add Reference. We can browse to the folder for program files, Autodesk, AutoCAD 2022, and the Civil3D folder. We then want to scroll down and find the AECC Data Shortcut MGD.dll file. And for the pressure networks, it's going to be AEccPressurePipesMgd.dll. And then press Add. It'll then be checked in the list, and then you can press OK. And it'll add the AEC data shortcuts and pressure pipes APIs. Down here, we have a copy local option, which we want to set to false. We want it to use the versions that Civil3D comes installed with, and so we don't need to copy them locally to where our DLL is going to be. We can then use the my commands to get a sample of how we can run our commands. We can have a plugin iExtension application that if we want to run some code when our DLL gets loaded, we can run that in the initialize. And then when our DLL is unloaded, when AutoCAD or Civil3D shuts down, we can do some stuff in terminate, but I don't believe this code is called. But I believe it does have to be there. And so this is just how you can set up your environment for Visual Studio to program. Once you have your code up and running, you'll want to debug it. To debug, you hit Start. And that's going to go ahead and open up Civil3D 2022. And then we may get this exception called loader lock. And we really don't care about this. It's just saying that something is going on that Visual Studio doesn't like. And to dismiss this so it doesn't come up again, we can hit the open exception settings, search in the search box for a loader lock, and we can uncheck the loader lock exception. So it'll no longer break when it's thrown. Then you can hit play to continue, and Civil3D will finish loading, and then you'll be able to debug it. And then to load the DLL, we can type netload at the command line. We can go to bin and debug, and then select our DLL. It's going to ask us if we trust it. We created it, so we're going to go ahead and hit always load. And then we should be able to type my command at the command line, which is the command name in the .NET wizard. And it's going to say, hello, this is your first command at the command line. All of the links at the beginning of the video are down below in the comments.